This year we're taking our scam and sense to the gym and putting muscles on it. Will you join us? Hi everyone, welcome to Planet Zhuzhu and Happy New Year! With one of the UK's banking groups, NatWest, reporting last October that more than 7 in 10 people were targeted with an average of 3 scams a week over the previous 12 months, and that's with an average loss of £350 per person, I think it's really time to train our scam and sense, take it to the gym and put muscles on it, as it were. So what's scam and sense? Well, simply put, it's like your common sense, but specifically honed towards fraudulent activity. It relies on critically appraising things to check for scammer activity, and to do that, you need to see plenty of scam activity to be able to recognise it. Just like when you look at a bunch of flowers, you automatically know whether or not there are any roses there. If you're hyper aware, you'll also realise those roses have thorns that might draw blood if you're not careful. But part of scam and sense means not keeping this information to yourself, but sharing it with your friends and family. You might think it's only vulnerable people who get scammed, but a huge target these days is young people under 25. So if you find this information useful, please share it, as it might just make someone stop and think before they lose money. So how are we going to do this? Last year, I logged all the scams I was targeted with in a week, and I made a video about it. I also explained how my phone is set up to detect potential scam calls even before I answer. So if you haven't watched that one, I'll put a link in the description, and I'm going to do the same thing, but I'm going to try and keep it going so that I have a much more comprehensive log covering the whole year. And I'm calling it Scamwatch 2024. I'll keep the basic thumbnails the same and just change the number in the series so you'll know exactly what to look for. Now this was just meant to be a quick New Year's video just introducing Scamwatch 2024, but I couldn't resist showing you a scam. So just for your entertainment, here's an email I received a couple of days ago. It has no dodgy URL links, just one of those QR code images attached. I've blanked part of it out so nobody inadvertently scans it. Hovering over that tells me it's a PNG image file, and it won't show me the name of the website it'll link to. It's bound to be dodgy though, so I haven't clicked on it or scanned it. There is evidence that even PNG files can have viruses or malware embedded in them. Now I don't read or speak any of the Chinese languages, but I can see the sender's email address, which shows me it comes from viva.site, and a quick domain check with whois shows me it comes from China. Who knew? But Google Translate is awesome, so I can bring you its scammy message. It's titled Annual Subsidy Receipt Notice, and it comes from Internal Company Notification. Dear colleagues, hope you are well. Policy: we sincerely inform all employees that they can now start applying for annual subsidies. All employees who have worked for the group for more than 6 months are eligible to participate in this subsidy program. In order to facilitate your application process, please scan the mini program QR code in the attachment of this notice to obtain detailed application steps and related details. We promise that once your application is successfully approved, we will issue an additional annual subsidy to express our gratitude and recognition for your unremitting efforts and outstanding contributions in the past year. Qualified employees are encouraged to take advantage of this unique opportunity. Please follow the guidelines provided in the attachment to ensure you can successfully complete your subsidy application. If you encounter any problems during the application process, or need further assistance, please feel free to contact the Human Resources Department. Our team is ready to provide you with the necessary support. Wish you the best at work. Sincerely, Human Resources Department. Now to me, since I don't work for anyone, let alone anyone in China, it's an obvious scam. But maybe it might trick someone who works for a Chinese company, and since they don't state which company, it could trick a lot of people. Now we know that they're asking for information on an application form, we know it's likely to be a phishing scam, but if you look at the wording where they talk about annual subsidies, and then you look at the age of the site, you'll see it's less than a year old. You'll also see that they updated it on the very day that email was sent. That suggests to me that perhaps a real company's website was hacked and they accessed its email function to send out scams as quickly as possible. Why my email address was available to them, I don't know, but it's possibly as a result of being on a customer database of a Chinese company I've ordered from in the past that has had a data breach. Well, I hope you found that interesting and that you'll join me in getting your scam and sense fit for 2024. Thanks for watching. And I hope to see you again soon.
Ooh, should have seen it coming.